Earlier today, we released our modeling on how we think this pandemic might unfold. The modeling shows that COVID-19 arrived in Canada later than in other countries. So we're in an earlier stage of the outbreak. That means we have the chance to determine what our country looks like in the weeks and months to come. Our healthcare systems across the country are coping for the time being. But we're at a fork in the road between the best and the worst possible outcomes. The best possible outcome is no easy path for any of us. The initial peak, the top of the curve, may be in late spring with the end of the first wave in the summer. As Dr. Tam explained, there will likely be smaller outbreaks for a number of months after that. This will be the new normal until a vaccine is developed.
If there are going to be multiple waves of this, if we aren't going to be able to sort of get out of this until we find a vaccine, which we're told is 12 to 18 months away at best, do you envision that we're going to have multiple waves of shutdowns, lockdowns, closures of the economy? And how can we handle those kinds of constant shutdowns?
I think even after we're through this first wave, we will need to remain vigilant and we will need to bring in different measures. Normality as it was before will not come back full on until we get a vaccine for this. And as you say, that could be a very long way off. But once we get through this first wave, we will have developed both tools and habits that will allow us to be much more resilient and resistant to further outbreaks and spreads that will be able to be kept localized, that will be able to fight against and protect our most vulnerable from over the coming months. It will require continued actions in different places and quick responses. But part of getting through this wave in a rapid way will be because we are developing the tools that will also help us when those wavelets come forward in the coming months.